Nuestro país no lanza bombas contra otros pueblos, ni manda miles de aviones a bombardear ciudades. Nuestro país no posee armas nucleares, ni armas químicas, ni armas biológicas. Las decenas de miles de científicos con que cuenta nuestro país y sus médicos han sido educados en la idea de salvar vida.
Cuba has been at the forefront of humanitarian activities since the start of the COVID-19 pandemic, and 42 Cuban medical brigades have been sent to 35 countries. Cuban medical professionals have attended to close to 300,000 patients. These efforts by Cuba's Henry Reeve International Medical Brigade have been the most significant example of medical internationalism during this pandemic. The brigade was set up in 2005 by Fidel Castro and has saved over 80,000 lives. It is part of a long and inspiring tradition of solidarity. In 1960, barely a year after the Cuban Revolution, a team of medical professionals set up 6 field hospitals in Chile following a devastating earthquake. Since then, close to 100,000 Cuban doctors have served in 37 Latin American, 33 African, and 24 Asian countries. They have helped countries who were affected by HIV/AIDS, Ebola, malaria, COVID-19, cyclones, and earthquakes. This internationalism and commitment to people's health goes back to the revolution itself. Revolutionary Cuba's commitment to universal healthcare for the people was evident from the very beginning in its investment in building a cadre of doctors. In 1958, before the Cuban Revolution, there was one doctor for every 1,051 people. Half of these would leave after the triumph of the revolution in order to continue to seek private gain in the United States and other countries. By 2007, Cuba had one doctor for every 155 citizens. Now let's compare this number with the developed world. Western Europe has one doctor for every 330 people, and the United States has one doctor for every 417 people. Thus, universal access to healthcare is fundamental to the revolutionary process. The Cuban system is characterized by universal quality healthcare that is freely provided for by the state. It focuses on prevention and is based on primary healthcare accompanied by social and community practice. For instance, in the 1980s, Cuba's health system spearheaded a program called Medicina General Integral, Comprehensive General Medicine. Its aims were to ensure that there was an allocation of one doctor and one nurse per neighborhood in the country. This proved to be successful, as by 2004, this program was able to serve more than 99% of the Cuban population. It is an ongoing and growing program today. Cuba has shown us that continuing with austerity policies will be disastrous, especially in the field of healthcare. It has shown us that it is possible to have a principled, compassionate, and scientific approach to the challenges of our future. Its doctors and government have put the lives of people throughout the world ahead of everything else. In recognition of this work, an international campaign has been launched calling for the Nobel Peace Prize to be awarded to the Cuban medical brigades.
I first came to wanting to be part of the campaign when I saw, not on US TV, but on, I think it might have been on Al Jazeera, a picture of the Cuban doctors arriving in Lombardy, Italy, which was the most infected part of Italy from the coronavirus, and seeing this wave of these healthcare workers getting off a plane, arriving in Italy, being applauded by the Italians waiting for them. And then the interviews that were being done with them when they talked to the doctors about why they were putting their lives at risk and weren't they scared. And I remember one doctor saying, yes, of course we're scared, but this is our debt to humanity. We are supposed to be helping people when they're in need, and the Italians are in need, and so we are here to support them. And it was just so beautiful and brought tears to my eyes, and I thought, wow. And then I read that there was a small solidarity group based out of France called Cuba Linda that had proposed that they get the Nobel Peace Prize, and I thought, wow, what a great idea. And reached out to the National Network on Cuba, where one of the co-chairs, Alicio Jeco, is already involved in this because it had been proposed by some other groups, like in Greece, and said, yes, great idea, let's be the US committee for this campaign. And so we started out gathering lots and lots of endorsements from all kinds of individuals with, like from Nobel Peace Prize winners in the past, from writers, artists, people in the academic world. And we have gathered together, now there's over 10,000 people who have signed up on this. We have a new website called Cuba Nobel, like Nobel Peace Prize, cubanobel.org, where people can join. And we have a very extensive social media plan on all the different platforms to get people talking about this, to make them understand just how beautiful this program is, and also to counter the kind of sabotage that the U.S. has been doing against this particular program now, and against Cuba's healthcare system in general, and of course, Cuba as an island since the revolution in 1959.